So with your line of credit, if you put your income in, bringing it to a zero where you can pull back out then and put onto a credit card. So your income is kind of working twice. First, it's going in here to knock this down to keep all of the interest charges off of it. Then
Okay.
it's transferring over here to pay onto this card to keep interest down here, but you're still paying your expenses. So say the gas and the food and whatever comes to $2,000 a month, and you're going to be putting it on this card. You would put your income in first. Now, that being said, you have a payment on that card of $419.
Yes.
You have 660 that you're showing in cash flow. So this would be your new cash flow, okay? So all of this would also go into this credit card. Does that make sense?
It does, yes.
So you would bet 8531, then yes, right. Yeah, these two added together would be 3079 would be going into this credit card.
Okay.
Then your 2000 in expenses would come back out here, and you're bringing the balance down over $1,000 every month, and then your interest would be average based on the average daily balance, and then it would be charged in the next month.
Okay.
That's one way that you can work out your credit card debt. You can also divide it up. So you have several credit cards, and you could divide up expenses through those cards, meeting the minimum payments, putting in $500 on each card or whatever. That also is going to help you to help with the interest charges and making that minimum payment, turning it into cash flow. So I'll send you videos to clear that up a little bit as to
Okay.
how that can be done, because I've got four or five I'll send you on that.
Okay.
Okay. Tell me what other. Now, I see you have a low credit score.
Correct.
So it's going to take you a minute of just working these credit cards to get that up. It should not take long at all. The secret with using credit cards is that you are putting as many minimum payments per month as you can. So if you can go in and put in two or three a week, dividing up, say, this 2000. If you were to put 20 a day, 100 a day, something like that, where you're revolving that account a lot, that for some reason increases your credit score pretty quickly and pretty high.
Oh,
Okay.
okay.
So I've had people get 40 points increase in next by the next reporting period, or I've had people get 121 points increase. So it just depends on what the credit cards are feeling like, I guess, the companies. But if you're revolving that account pretty often, like I said, every day, every other day, you go to the grocery store today, spend $100, put in $100 tomorrow, just revolving that account to really boost your scores. Once those scores are up just a little bit, about 660,
Right.
you can turn around and maybe have this personal line increase so that you can get more out of it.
That's the ultimate goal, is to try and increase the line of credit.
Right, so let me look at your home. That's a very, very good option on getting you a big line of credit so that you can really knock out some debt fast.
Right, and that's why I wanted to try and increase the credit score so I can then hopefully get a HELOC,
Okay,
utilize
so
that
if
to.
you watch, right, and if you watch the videos that I'm going to send you, and apply those to your credit cards, you will get up to where you can get the HELOC pretty quickly.
Okay.
Maybe as soon as your next reporting date. So just really focus on how you're using those credit cards, and that should knock you up to where you need to be. Once you are there, your debt's going to be no problem. You're going to be able to really work this down fast. And for an example, if you've got a $50,000 line of credit through a HELOC and you paid off most of your credit cards, that's going to gain you $1,626 a month in cash flow on top of this 660 that you already have. And you know, you're paying the 89 or the $90 right now on the line of credit. So all of these strategies can be worked together to where when your income goes in here now, and I think it was 9,800.
That is correct.
Okay, so let's say it's just 9,000
Okay.
and you're bringing this down. So income in, then your expenses would come back out. And because your expenses are going to be closer to 70, let's say they're at 7,100 as well, your expenses. So you're at 48,100. You're going to be looking at even 308 in interest charges, which that would be very high, but let's just pretend.
Now that interest is based on What
the going rate right now.
Okay, gotcha.
So the going rate right now is 9%. That's the high. So if you go to look for a HELOC, you would definitely want to look about, you know, if somebody's trying to give you a 12% on a HELOC, that's like ridiculous. You shouldn't be doing that.
Okay.
That being said, so this would essentially be paid off in less than 18 months, paying off the $50,000. Now, we wouldn't sit and just wait 50 months. You would do it 6 months approximately and then turn around and grab your Pathfinder and start throwing chunks onto that and paying that off. So you're never just sitting waiting, you know, for a year to come. You're working while you're letting your HELOC work down the other debt as well. So does that make sense? And if not, or whatever, ask questions, because I need to know what you're thinking.
Yeah, it does make sense. So I just want to make sure, I just have to continue making the minimum payments until I have be able to make chunks towards the next thing. That's what my understanding.
Right. So your credit cards are, of course, the 0% ones, you would want to leave them alone and just keep making minimum payments until it's time to pay them off.
Correct.
But your consolidated loan and your personal loan, those two, I would knock them out before you get to your Pathfinder, because they are really ridiculous on those rates.
Yeah, that that consolidated loan, yeah, it's really, really hitting my pockets very hard every month, so.
Yeah, I mean, I can imagine, because that's $1,717 a month. I mean, that's $770 a month.
Yes, right.
Right. You know, if you can save any kind of money, like, for example, you've got $400 in emergency here, all of that can go into the line of credit and sit and wait until you need it or you have an urgent need. So that's what I said. You're going to be moving faster than what, you know, my numbers here would show.
Okay.
Because life does happen, but we just take it out of the line when it does happen. That way we're not, you know, our money is always working for us. That's the whole point.
Now, as far as cash that I currently have in investment brokerage account, would you recommend utilizing those as well to speed up the process? Or because I'm not making any contributions currently, but I do have some cash there.
That is your decision. I don't usually mess with any kind of 401ks or anything.
Gotcha.
Sometimes, maybe, but they're at 8% right now, so the payment is really taking the cash flow away from what you need to be putting it maybe towards debt. So that's a wash sometimes, and I would kind of have to see different situations. I don't think that you need to do that.
Okay.
Just because you have cash flow right now, and as soon as you work into a line of credit, you're going to free up more cash flow. So I don't think that you need to do that. If you feel like that you do, of course, you know, have at it, but I don't think that you're in that position.
Okay. It just feels overwhelming from time to time. You're trying to make all these different payments. So.
Yeah. And that's what, as soon as you get your credit score worked up, we're talking a month or two. It's not going to take you long.
Okay.
Maybe just a few. But as soon as you get that score up over 660, 680 for sure, go step into a HELOC and wipe out this credit card debt and get that off of you.